I'm at the Wildebeestkuil rock-art site in Kimberley, and this is a very interesting site as it's a mixture of evolution. We have hand axes dating back to about 500,000, and we also have rock engravings dating back to about 2,000 years ago. And it goes back to archaeology. It tells us about how people lived and what they used during those times.
One of the exciting parts of the site is that obviously the key focus and what people come here to see is mainly the rock art, the rock engravings. But there's a tremendous wealth of different layers, if you like, of the human past, right from hand axe times, perhaps 500,000 or more years ago, and to traces that are much younger, dating from the pre-colonial past as well as the colonial era. We've got stone walling, stone kraals. There are traces of two hotel sites dating from the 1870s after diamonds were discovered in the immediate vicinity.
All around us are rock engravings, and because this place was high above water, people think it has a spiritual significance.
Yeah, there's a full elam. That was actually one of the favorite animals of this area. Yeah, if you go the other side of the Limpopo, they will find the kudu is actually more important on that side. And here you will find, especially when you come up here, we're mostly finding elam on this area. Yeah, the rituals, they will only slaughter the elam when there's rituals, and maybe when before you can get married, you must go and hunt in Ireland also, to become a man also.
Yeah, so around the area, it actually looks like a horse, this one here. But if we take into perspective the age, the dating of this place, between 1,000 and 2,000 years, we actually didn't have, there's no evidence of horses around here. Maybe zebra, maybe quagga, yes, but there's no physical evidence of horses.
We speak of how the San people, and we know it from the records of the Kum in the 1870s, how they drew on the elements to express some of their religious beliefs. Water is a principal one that's used, and often we think that a lot of the rock art might have something to do with rain making. But wind is another of the elements that people refer to in the Kum records, in the Kum stories. And they speak about stories being like the wind. And so we've used that as a bit of an element here in the development of the site to talk about beliefs that have come to the present like stories on the wind. We also refer to the wind as being a feature that has been a factor in the formation of this landscape, how the pans are formed by wind blowing the dust out of them. So one can use these aspects of the environment to interpret the site.